Everyone, my name is Iris Franz, and today we're going to continue to talk about absolute and comparative advantage. In particular, I'm going to show you with production possibility curve how two countries can specialize on the good that they have a comparative advantage and both benefit from trade. So we're going to continue with our example from last time. We have two countries, USA and China. We have two goods, ibuprofen and shoes. And this is their productivity. In 1 hour, USA can produce either 10 bottles of ibuprofen or 5 pairs of shoes. And for China, in each labor hour, they can either produce 2 bottles of ibuprofen or 2 pairs of shoes. And in the previous video, we calculated that USA has an absolute advantage in both ibuprofen and shoes. And China has an absolute disadvantage in both ibuprofen and shoes. However, China has a comparative advantage in the production of shoes, whereas USA has a comparative advantage in the production of ibuprofen. So if you don't remember that, please go back to the previous video and, you know, review it before we continue. And so here will be their production possibility curve. So suppose China has 10 labor hours and USA has 8 labor hours. So that's a resource they have. And we know production possibility curve will show you how much goods and services they can produce with all the resources. Now, given that China has 10 labor hours, if China uses all the labor hours to produce ibuprofen, then it will be able to produce 20 bottles of ibuprofen and no shoes. Alternatively, China can be using that 10 labor hours to produce only shoes and no ibuprofen. And in that case, they will be able to produce 20 pairs of shoes and no ibuprofen. And then you connect the two points, you get China's production possibility curve. How about US? US has 8 labor hours, and if USA used all labor hours, all the 8 hours to produce ibuprofen only, then it can produce 80 bottles of ibuprofen and no shoes. But if USA used all the 8 hours to produce shoes, it will be able to produce 8 times 5, so 40 pairs of shoes and no ibuprofen. So look, I'm putting ibuprofen on the horizontal axis and shoes on the vertical axis, same as China. Now, suppose without trade, so under autarky, meaning we're not going to trade with each other, then you consume whatever you produce. And you can produce on this production possibility curve, so you will never be able to consume outside of it without trade. So suppose without trade, China allocated 5 hours on ibuprofen production and 5 hours on shoe production. Then China will be able to produce 10 bottles of ibuprofen and 10 pairs of shoes. Then that will be this point. I mark it A. A stands for autarky, so we're not trading. Okay, China produce and consume at this point. What about US? Suppose they allocate 6 hours on ibuprofen and 2 hours on shoe production. In that case, the US will be able to produce 60 bottles of ibuprofen and 10 pairs of shoes. So without trade, the USA will produce and consume at point A prime. Now suppose the two countries are going to open up their border and trade, and each of them will focus on the good that it has a comparative advantage. So in that case, USA will be specializing on ibuprofen, whereas China will be specializing on shoes. So China will be producing shoes only and no ibuprofen, so China will produce at point B. Whereas US will specialize on ibuprofen, so USA will be produced at point B prime, so only ibuprofen and no shoes. And now we're going to open up to trade. So suppose USA is going to export 15 bottles of ibuprofen in exchange for 10 pairs of shoes. So what will happen? So USA is producing here, and USA is going to export 15 bottles of ibuprofen, so USA is moving to the left. And the story doesn't just end there, because USA will import 10 pairs of shoes from China. So we're going to increase the number of shoes by moving up. And therefore, USA is going to consume at point C prime, where we have 65 bottles of ibuprofen, because they produce 80 bottles, and export 15 bottles of ibuprofen. So USA is left with 65 bottles of ibuprofen. And USA will gain 10 pairs of shoes from China, because that's our import. So we consume at point C prime. Now, does China lose out? No, it also gains from trade. So China produced at point B, and China is going to sell the shoes to the States. So we're going to move down 10 units because China is going to ship the shoes, 10 pairs, to the States. And the story doesn't just end there, because the US is going to ship 15 bottles of ibuprofen to China. So we're moving to the right until we hit point C, where we have 15 bottles of ibuprofen and 10 pairs of shoes. So you see, China also gain from trade. So without trade, you consume whatever you produce, and you produce a production possibility curve. It's not possible for you to produce outside of production possibility curve. But now, with trade, both countries can consume outside the production possibility curve. So both countries gain from trade. Here's a reason why countries all like to trade. Because even though China has an absolute disadvantage in both products, it can still gain from trade by focusing on the good that it has a comparative advantage. And here's also the reason why Western European countries like Germany or France like United States of America, or American countries, we like to trade with less developed countries like India and China, even though more developed countries has an absolute advantage in almost everything, in aircraft, in chemicals, in textile, in clothing. But usually less developed countries, they have a comparative advantage in textile and shoes. That's where we trade. And I hope you find this video helpful. And if you find this helpful, please share with your friends who find economics challenging. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your studying.